When gold is on the move, are you better off being in the royalty companies? We're speaking with Eric Jensen. He's the general manager of exploration over at EMX Royalty during the Swiss Mining Institute here, day one in Zurich. Eric, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Danielle.
So I have to say, this is probably one of the top questions I get asked by investors is when they're looking at their portfolio and they're deciding and picking amongst the companies, they ask, you know, are we better off with the price movement right now picking a royalty company over the miners? Now, obviously, you have your biases.
Yeah, we have our bias for sure, but that should be part of any investor's portfolio. And the best rationale for that is to look at the last decade of performance in our sector, how the royalty companies have done versus the other exploration and mining companies. The outperformers in the sector have been the royalty companies. And as metal prices increase, the margins for royalties and royalty payments increase as well.
So help us understand a little bit of, you know, if gold is rallying here, why would royalty companies tend to outperform versus just a miner?
Well, I'm not going to guarantee that, but I'm going to say the performance will be naturally strong during a time period like that, because the royalties have some unusual upsides that may not be obvious to the average investor. Again, going back to the last 10 years, those companies have simply outperformed the rest of the sector. And a lot of that has to do with something, when you boil it all down, it comes back to the optionality of a royalty interest. When you have a royalty on a producing asset, in exploration, most of our success globally comes in the immediate vicinity of active mines. That's where most of our ounces or our tons of metal come from in terms of new discoveries. So when you own a royalty, through time, the continued exploration and development will create additional value and additional resources that the royalty will pay.
And Eric, oftentimes, you know, we tend to lump royalty and streamers together, but there's a big difference there.
There can be, but they both fundamentally work in the same way, in that you're basically benefiting from the future production. You have a percentage or a right to purchase at a discount future production from an ongoing operation, and through time they'll discover more and more metal, and your royalty doesn't change. The royalty never gets diluted. It continues to grow through time and value as a result.
So let's talk about assets you like and what EMX's kind of game plan is. You've been around 15 years.
Yeah. We do think we're a bit of a different animal in terms of the royalty companies. What we specialize in doing is we generate our own royalties. Most of these companies go out and buy royalties on the market, which can be exceedingly expensive. Companies typically pay significant premiums for royalties if you try to bid them for existing royalties.
It's not like the Franco model, for example.
Yeah, it's a little bit different than that. What we do is we have teams of geologists that go out, find exploration opportunities, we acquire those, then we sell them to partner companies for a royalty, so we keep a royalty, and we also get our cash, and sometimes share equity in the partner that helps repay us for our acquisition costs.
So 2018 was a good deal for you guys.
It was a great year for us,
You know, cash generation, deal flows, what's next, what's the game plan?
Yeah, 2018 was a fantastic year for EMX, and if you look at our share price performance over the past 18 months, we've got a great chart that's very different than most of the junior resource sector. We've done very well. So in terms of deal flow, we signed more agreements, generated more cash from our agreements last year than we've ever done. And we'd also monetized some assets on the strategic investment side, which gave us a lot of cash in our treasury. So right now, our company has $120 million market cap. Two-thirds of that is cash in the bank. And we've got a lot of commercial activity taking place. And 2019 looks like it's going to follow a similar path.
Right.
A lot of deals in the works in the making right now.
Eric Jensen, thank you so much for joining us here on the sidelines of the Swiss Mining Institute. Thank you.
Yeah, very exciting time.
And thanks for watching. We'll have more for you on Kitco.com. Thanks,
thank
Eric.
You. Cheers.
Fine, gonna take some time, gonna make her mind, gonna make